But he was also a very kind person. He was the kind of person that would give himself totally to others. So we have seasons of the year where we give our children big gifts, you know, like Aidiya, we call them. And Ali would never buy a video game unless he buys his friend the same video game. His friend was not very, capable of buying everyone. When I decided to buy him a car, being a spoiling father that I am, I said, "Hey, Ali, anything you want, a convertible Porsche if you want." And Ali decides, of course, not to do that, right? He decides to buy a car that is for his band, where he can have, you know, their amps and guitars and what have you, and drives everyone around all the time. I think the one event that completely I will always remember is we were in Boston, and Ali, he studied in Boston in Northeastern University, and Ali would walk to an old homeless lady and sit next to her, literally at least 40 minutes. I didn't count exactly, but he sat next to her chatting for such a long time. And, you know, it wasn't like he gave her a dollar and went away. He was actually making her feel recognized, making her feel human. And then he basically emptied his pockets, gave her everything he had, which I think is, you know, not the biggest thing, but is very kind for a young man who has an allowance, and walked away. And so I saw her chasing him, digging deep into her sack and getting out a box of hand cream, unopened, which in my view was probably her biggest treasure. Like, this is the one thing that she said, you know, when it's a great day, I'll open this thing, right? And gave that to him, and that became his biggest treasure until it's now our biggest treasure. Some of you know. The other thing, sorry, about Ali is that he was so wise that by age 18, I started to go to him for everything. Like, literally, I'm not making this up. If I'm stuck in something at work or in life, I would go to Ali and say, "Ali, what do you think of this?" And in his very interesting way, he would just ask a few questions, and then smile, and then sit quietly, and then say one sentence, like literally one sentence, and I would go like, "Yeah, that sounds right." Okay. He was so wise that at age 18, I publicly said to a lot of my friends, "When I grow up, I want to be like Ali." Okay. I'm not making this up. Ali, unfortunately. He lived in Boston. He called us in May of 2014, was it? Yeah. And he basically said, "Guys, I know I wasn't planning to be here for summer, but I really feel very compelled to come and see you." Took a flight, came over. 4 days later, he was diagnosed with an appendicitis. Is that the right English word? And so we took him to a hospital. This is basically the simplest operation on the face of the planet, right?